As Kratos stepped out into the eternal night, much had changed outside the temple. Morpheus grew ever stronger as his harbingers of darkness continued their relentless march.
Come on. must hurry, Kratos.
As Kratos entered the cave, Eos, goddess of dawn and sister to Helios, sat above him, visibly weakened by the absence of the sun.
All glory be to Lord Zeus for granting you safe passage to me.
The king of the gods does not aid me, Eos. I am but a slave to Zeus and Olympus.
Save my brother, Kratos, and he will convince Zeus to release you and rid you of the horrors of your past. I give you my word.
The gods have broken their word to me many times. Forgive me if I find it hard to believe your promises.
Be that as it may, Kratos, the primordial fire is almost out. Without Helios, the life-giving light of the world cannot be sustained. If you do not find him, only darkness and death awaits all of us.
Where has Atlas taken him?
I do not know, Kratos. Follow the passage out of the cave. Retrieve the fire, and it will light your path to the remaining steeds. They will guide you to their master. They will take you to my brother. May you go with the speed of Hermes, Ghost of Sparta. Hurry, Kratos.
Ah!
And again, the melody returned. And it almost seemed familiar. As Kratos left the temple, he was assaulted by the army of Morpheus, and again, he heard the haunting melody. But this time, he recognized it as the song of his daughter, Calliope.
Calliope? My daughter, where are you? Calliope!
With the release of the fire steeds, Kratos was now in the hands of the beasts. And where they would take him, he did not know. As the steeds pulled Kratos away from the grip of Morpheus, they crossed into the underworld. But in the land of the dead, they could go no further, for these beings of light were not welcome in Hades. Kratos found himself on the very edge of Hades, the land where no mortal had set foot. Here, where the souls of the dead walk their fated path, Kratos knew that for him, this was merely the beginning.